The snowflake was born on a cold winter's day, far up in the sky, many miles above the earth. Falling, 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 as gently as lying in a cradle rocked by the wind, drifting downward like a feather, blown this way and that, Snowflake found herself floating in a world she had never known before. She thought to herself, "Here I am, but where did I come from? And what was I then? Where have I been? Where am I going? Who made me and all my brothers and sisters all about me? And why?" There was no answer to these questions. Looking about her, Snowflake could see hundreds upon hundreds of other flakes tumbling down as far as the eye could reach, and they were silent too. It was strange, Snowflake thought, to see so many of her brothers and sisters, newborn like herself, on every side, and yet to feel so alone. No sooner had she thought this, when it seemed as though she became aware that all about her there was a kind of dear and tender love. The feeling as of someone caring, that filled her through and through with warmth and sweetness. As dawn began to come to the dark world through which Snowflake was tumbling on her long journey to the earth, the sky turned first the blue color of steel, then gray, then pearl. And looking at herself as she tumbled over and over, fragile and airy as the wind that blew her, Snowflake knew that she was beautiful. While there were millions of flakes born of the same storm, each was different from the other. Snowflake felt grateful to the one who'd given her such beauty, and wished she knew how it came about that in an instant he was able to create them all, each one as lovely as a jewel, and yet no two of them alike. Soon, Snowflake could make out objects below her. Dark tops of mountains and slopes of snow, forests of trees standing up straight, and on the side of a hill, a village with houses and barns, and a church with a round steeple shaped like an onion. Snowflake landed gently, with hardly a jar, in a field on the mountainside, just outside the village, and the journey was over. The wind blew the clouds away, the sky became brighter, and then a miracle began to happen. First, the very tip of the snow-capped mountain peak across the valley was touched with delicate rose. Slowly it spread to the next summit, and then the next. The snow everywhere was touched with it, and soon even the air itself was filled with pinkness, as though the whole world were but the mirror of a rose petal. And Snowflake, too, saw that she was no longer white, but bathed like everything else in this soft and beautiful color. Snowflake thought it was so beautiful, it made her want to cry. It was her first sunrise. Later in the morning, Snowflake had a surprise. Down the hill, on a high wooden sled with steel runners, came a little girl with flaxen pigtails, bright blue eyes, and red cheeks like two rubber balls. She was the merriest little girl, and she sat bravely upright on her sled, wearing a red cap and red mittens on her fingers. As she passed over, the steel runner cut deeply into Snowflake's heart and hurt her cruelly, so that she gave a little cry. But the girl did not hear. She was quickly gone, and only her joyous shouts drifted back in the cold morning air. Now that the storm was over and the day had come, everybody in the village went about his business again. The cold, clear winter's day was filled with the sound of sawing and chopping and hammering and planing, with snuffling and grunting and crowing and clucking. One night, it began to snow again. A new snowstorm lasted all day and all night, and when it was over, Snowflake was buried under many feet of the new fall. It was quite dark, and she could no longer see anything. She strained eagerly for all the well-known sounds that told her that even while she lay buried and forgotten, life in the village was going on. Thus began a new life for Snowflake, and it was not a happy one. Each time there was a fresh storm, or the rain fell, turned the surface to a hard crust of ice, it grew deeper and darker where she lay. Soon, even the sounds barely came through to her. What made Snowflake the saddest was the thought that she had been abandoned by the one who had created her, and whose love had made her feel so happy and secure in the cradle of the wind when first she was born. She said, "Dear one who made me, have you forgotten me? I'm lonely and afraid. Please help me. Take me out of the darkness and let me see the light once more." And having asked that, she added timidly, "I love you." As soon as she had said that, she no longer felt so lonely, but happy and excited instead, as though perhaps something wonderful might be about to happen to her. It began first with a strange drumming that sounded from overhead and seemed to go on endlessly. It was the noise made by rain when first it falls in the early spring upon the hard crust of the winter's snow. The long rains at last had filtered down from above, and the waters were moving restlessly beneath the layers of frozen snow and ice that still covered the earth. The darkness in which she had lived so long turned to deep blue, then emerald green, changing to yellow as though a strong light was shining through a heavy veil. The next moment, as though by magic, the veil was lifted. Overhead, the sun, warm and strong, burned from a cloudless sky. Snowflake was free once again. Her heart gave a great shout. "The sun! The sun! Dearly beloved sun! How glad I am to see you!" What a different world it was from the mass of gray and white into which she had been born. Now everything was fresh and green and carpeted with flowers. All about her now there was the rushing, liquid music of running waters. Because of the great joy and happiness she felt, Snowflake too began to run. She ran through a quiet wood and awakened the first violet beneath its broad green leaf. She ran. And as she did so, she noticed for the first time that something strange had happened to her. A most wondrous and exciting change had taken place. Snowflake was no longer a lace-like creature of stars and crosses, triangles and squares, all woven into one pattern that was all her own. Now she was round and as pure as the morning light, crystal clear, and like a tiny silver mirror, she was able to catch and give back every color in the world about her. And there was another change that had taken place as well. Snowflake could not stop running when she'd started down the hill. She did not know that she had begun a long journey.
Could not stop running while she had started down there.
That she must run evermore, but not until the end of her days. Would she ever again be still?